technology has made a significant contribution to literature, travel economy, and the black economy. Earlier, put on black economy.
So, Mike, I just.
Earlier book on black economy stands out as a major reference work on Indian public policy. A lot has been written, discussed, debated. There are still many, many questions unanswered. Main question I've been grappling with, and I have a suggestion for consideration of all of you. What were the real reasons for the whole exercise? According to me, there are three reasons. Maybe there are more. One, publicly stated, as stated by the Prime Minister on the 8th of November, very passionate speech, as if he was rolling out a revolution. He believed what he said. But there are two other objectives which is unstated. The second objective was to hit at the political funding of opposition parties. And they were caught unawares, and we all know that they got hit. I think at least to the tune of a third, which was paid as commissions in getting money converted to gold route or to real estate route or to banks and RBI and Nexus. So the opposition parties got hit, and to that extent, the second objective, although never stated publicly, was achieved substantially. The third objective, according to me, and that needs really research by academicians and all that, is we look at the events which happened overseas, particularly in the United States, and link it up to what's happening here. After the 2008 Lehman Brothers crisis, US Congress enacted what is popularly called Dodd-Frank Amendment, which completely overhauled the Wall Street architecture. One of the amendments is that Dodd-Frank was a Durbin Amendment, which sought to cap the commissions paid on debit cards in the United States, almost 50%, for an average of 45 cents per transaction, about 21, 22 cents in transaction, which hit the credit card industry and the entire financial technology industry by to the tune of $16 billion. Now, they were looking for alternate market. China is not available. China has their own system, Union Pay and all that. India looked like lucrative market. The story begins, I think, the visit of the President Barack Obama in January 15, where he gets our Prime Minister to agree to India becoming member of a newly constructed organization abroad, an organization called Better Than Cash Alliance. A lot has been written about it, like a secretive organization, which is nothing but a trade organization, the credit card companies, and the philanthropic front of the major fintech companies like Microsoft and Apple and all the big ones. Now, series, if you examine what happened in India after that, every single credit card company, whether it's Visa, the MasterCard, Citi, the Boston Consulting Group and Google, they produced reports and advised the government that India should completely go cashless, completely go digital. One report said that if you go digital, there'll be 1.7% gain to the 1.7% GDP gain to the Indian economy. India, after Obama visit, becomes member of the Better Than Cash Alliance. This is a Washington-based organization, nothing but a trade organization of the fintech and credit card company. I should comment that India become member of that organization is something which needs to be investigated. Later on, after these series of reports come, US aid comes in the picture. And USA and Finance Ministry forms this India-specific corporation called Gratico, called Catalyst. And the Catalyst's stated objective is to drive India towards a digital economic status. Now, any attempt to get information about why did India become a member of BTCA, why did India join and with USA to form this Catalyst, nothing has been replied. All RBI queries blank, nothing. Even the Indo-US agreement which talks about BGCL was not available on the India website, it has to be sourced from White House. So all these corporations very clearly indicate that there is something going on. Now what we are saying is that yes, digitization, why not? You should, it's more efficient way of doing it. But who will cap the commissions? Has anybody looked at commissions? The last budget, finance minister said that he will create what is called a payments regulatory authority under RBI. What has happened? No mention of it this month. And as a matter of fact, while other countries have a very minimal commission on this credit card and debit card transactions, 0.21%, 0.25%, we still have 0.75%. The whole purpose of the Durbin Amendment in the United States was to cap this commission. Why is Government of India not capping this commission? Why not regulating this financial technology sector? And that gives a lot of suspicion about there's something funny going on. And that is why our party has demanded a parliamentary inquiry, a joint parliamentary inquiry into those. Thank you.